Welcome to our new Bach Factory program on Bach's cantata 77, Du sollt Gott deinen Herren lieben, which is, of course, a cantata about love. However, Rudy, what kind of love?
If we think of the lovely song, na 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 ni di, ra da di di, ra da 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 di da, that's very unhappy love, human love. But ladies and gentlemen, in this case, it's the love. Our love to God. You should love God with all your strength, with all your soul, with your spirit and everything. And you should also not hate your neighbor. Love him. And even love enemy, that's another question. It's Jesus, and of course it's also the law of Moses. And in this first choir you hear a very well-known hymn. People sung a lot. Die sind die heiligen zehn Gebot. Xoán, what's that in English?
Oh, these are the Ten Commandments.
The Ten Commandments, and you hear this hymn, you hear it in the trumpet, you hear it in the bass, you hear it in the choir, you hear it in the violins, in smaller, in larger, in very large notes.
So this is a highly complex opening choir. What we're going to do is the following thing. We will listen to an excerpt of the opening choir just to give you an idea of what it's all about. And then we will explain the cantata shortly and we will focus on the opening choir and its complexity at the end of the program again. So let's now listen to this opening choir. We will get back to this opening choir in the second part of our program. But now we move on to the second movement, which is a bass recitative. Bum, 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 bum. Loving God as the basis of believing, isn't it, Rudy?
Yes, it says, so muss es sein. That's how it has to be. It's actually repeating what the choir was singing. God wants your heart. Alone, just he. He's jealous if you don't do that, you know. You must love him with your whole soul, with your bliss. You have to be enlightened by the Spirit of God, and you will be sure that his grace and his favor will be with you. Listen to the beginning of this impressive bass recitative. So muss es sein. Would you like to sing that with us? So muss es sein. Xoán, will you sing with us, please? So muss es sein. So you see, Bach always uses that exact motive which is the best for to express an idea. And then, like goes on, you can hear the first few notes. Gott will das Herz für sich alleine haben. Man muss den Herrn von ganzer Seele zu seiner Lust erwählen und sich nicht mehr erfreuen. Very little music, very much language that you know actually what's happening.
We'll now focus on the next aria, number 3, which is a soprano aria, really about loving God with very, very high intensity. Mein Gott, ich liebe dich von Herzen. I love you with all my heart. Lass mich doch dein Gebot erkennen und in Liebe so entbrennen, dass ich dich ewig lieben kann. So here, she's really catching on fire for God, isn't she?
Yes, one hears it in the coloraturas when Miriam is accompanied by two oboes and a basso continuo. And I think it would be lovely to hear a few bars of this tremendous aria.
Burning love aria. Beautiful aria. But now in the next movement, number four, the tenor recitative, there comes a new aspect of love, namely loving your neighbor. Really.
Exactly. It's now the scribe in the story in the Bible who asks Jesus, now, what must I do if I want to really love my neighbor? Then he says, I'll tell you a story. And then comes this touching story of the good Samaritan who doesn't walk pass by like the clergymen do, but says, here, that poor guy, I'll help him, I'll bring him to the hospital, and I'll see that he's got something to eat and to drink. And now the recitative mentions this. It's the Samariterherz, the heart of the Samaritan, I think you say it like that in English, accompanied with strings. I'll play you the beginning.
Gib mir dabei, mein Gott, ein Samariterherz, dass ich zugleich den Nächsten liebe und mich bei seinem Schmerz.
Did you hear that?
Not und mich bei seinem Schmerz, but und mich bei seinem Schmerz auch über ihn betrübe.
And so on.
That's quite a complicated thing, isn't it, Rudy? Do you always love your neighbor like that? And that's actually the topic of the next movement of the alto aria, which talks about the impossibility of love. Of love is something which is perfectly imperfect.
Yes, I consider you're quite right. It's very difficult to always love everybody, and especially your enemies. You should also do that. And now, what does Bach do in this situation? I'll try to explain it to you. Ladies and gentlemen, you've got this melody, a little bit melancholic. The alto sings, ach, es bleibt in meiner Liebe lauter Unvollkommenheit. And the instrument accompanying the alto, of course, is the basso continuo, and as obbligato instrument, you haven't got a violin or an oboe who would do this beautifully, but you have a trumpet. And you know that you can't play all notes on a trumpet, on a baroque trumpet, so if you listen to the beginning, tam pim bam pim, that's possible, and then this note, dim bam bam, you have to try to correct it. It really shows what's actually happening. Xoán, what do you think? Would be fine to listen a bit of this aria?
Let's listen to the aria with the trumpet and the basso continuo and, of course, the alto. Now the cantata closes down with a chorale. Something very funny happened to us when we prepared the performance, because we printed the wrong text on the booklet. We knew, we thought, that the melody was right, but the text was wrong. So what happened there, Rudy?
Well, normally Johann Sebastian Bach, he says exactly, I want to have this text. And now in the cantata, we don't find any text. So the Neue Bach-Ausgabe, the new Bach edition, decided to take Herr durch den Glauben wohn in mir, lass ihn sich immer stärken, dass sei fruchtbar für und für. Well, the text actually is fine, but Petzold, one of the great searchers on the Bach texts, said, I've got a better one. Ach, Herr, ich wollte ja dein Recht und deinen heiligen Willen, wie mir's gebührt als deinen Knecht ohn Mangel gern erfüllen. Well, what shall I say? It should be a summary of the chorale. And here it says, you know, I've done my best, I try to do it, I try to love my neighbor, but I always fail. I imagine it might have been the same guy who says, Amazing Grace, you know, the song of the poor old sinner, hoping for forgiveness. And the dismal melody, well, you've got here, Ach, Herr, ich wollte ja dein Recht und deinen heiligen Willen, really suits this text we chose to end this great cantata.
And as we promised in the beginning of our program, we're now going to go back to the opening choir. We said in the beginning it was highly, highly complex, and so in order to explain it, we have prepared five layers of complexity. We're going to start with the first one and find out what Bach is doing there with his composition.
You see three violin and viola players on the scene, and they take this motif. And now, if you start now at the back of this motif, it goes dee da 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 dee dee dee. And you hear, if you turn this up and down, dee da 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 da, you come to the chorale. And so Bach, that's my opinion about this idea, he says, the complexity of the law of Moses is depicted in the complexity of the counterpoint. We could listen to these first few bars.
Now there comes layer number two, and the choir comes in with Philip Rayo conducting it.
That was layer two, and now comes layer three. Philip is conducting the choir, I'm conducting the strings, and you will see her popping up. It's Damaris Nussbaumer taking the trumpet, but we said to the trumpet player, you mustn't play for this introduction, so we took an oboe. The next layer, number three.
So you hear, ladies and gentlemen, the thing is getting richer and richer. We now move on to layer number four, and the basso continuo comes in, the organ, the violone, the cello. Listen to it.
Und jetzt mit Ofenrohr.
What did you say? Ofenrohr?
Yes, I said Ofenrohr. That's not a musical instrument, that's a chimney pipe or a stovepipe. And you see it over there, that huge thing, it's a contrafagot, a double fagot. Bach used this bassone grosso in his John's Passion, and I thought, because the cantus firmus in long notes, descend, die heiligen, it's the cantus firmus in four times longer time. I imagine in Leipzig, Bach said to his organist, take the bassoon 16 foot on the organ with the pedals. We haven't got that, of course, so I asked for a contrafagot, which gives this incredible gravity to an incredibly complex piece.
Fifth layer and final layer. It is quite a remarkable, dense construction, and so we hope to have given you a bit of insight into the complexity of the piece and the rest of the cantata, of course. Bach, by the way, loved this chorale very, very much, and he used it in various other pieces, including organ pieces and choral pieces, but that's another story. Thank you very much for watching, and see you another time.
Peace.